fellow Toastmasters and welcome guests. Life is like a kitty park. I remember when I was just a little girl and we would get very excited when we got the opportunity to go to Memphis Kitty Park, right by where we used to have our meetings at American Dream. We didn't have a lot of money and that was a very special time for us. We always looked forward to that activity in the summertime. We'd hop in the car, we'd get to the park and we were very excited to pay the money. And then we'd stand there and wonder, which ride should we go on first? And isn't that the way life is? We had to pick which one we want to do first or which things we want to do. So we'd run over to where the boat ride was. The boat ride would go around. It actually had water. You could dip your hands in the water and sprinkle your friends. Remember those bells on the front where you could ring the bell and you felt like you had so much power? And it reminded me a lot of row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Because it was a nice, slow, quiet, peaceful ride. Then we would run over to the Jeeps, get in the Jeep ride, put on our seatbelts, have a steering wheel. We would start moving the steering wheel even before the ride started. We thought we had so much control. And then the ride would go around and around and around. Isn't that how life is sometimes? You feel like you have control, but the world is just taking you for a ride. Then we'd run over to the train. The train would go all around the park. We got to see everything and all the items that were going on in the displays. And lots of times during life, we just chug along like the little train that could. I guess that was what it's called. Then we would run over to the merry-go-round. And as soon as they let us on, we'd hop on the platform and pick out which beautifully painted horse we wanted. Then they'd hop up on there and go up and down and around on that ride. And how often do we want to pick the perfect color of our car or our outfit or our house? We all pick different things, but we're all just going around in a circle. And some people prefer to just sit on the benches and not even ride the horse and watch the world go around. And then, of course, there's the Little Dipper. Got in that ride, buckled up our seatbelts, and held on for dear life as the ride would slowly crank itself up to the top and then down and around and up and around. And that's how life is. We live in a very dualistic world where sometimes things go up and sometimes things go around and down and then all around. And part of life is the ups and downs that we balance out. And then, of course, there was the Ferris wheel. Do you remember the Ferris wheel for those of you out there? You climb in there, that little metal cage, they'd lock the door, and then it would start rocking. Nothing was happening, but it started rocking. And then it would go up a little bit as the people on the bottom got to go in their ride. And then it would go a little bit further and a little bit further, and then finally you were at the very top. And you could look around everything in the park, the dance and the colors and the movement and the motion of everyone in the park. That reminds me of oftentimes when something happens in your life, you look at it and you wonder, why did this happen? Maybe you lose a job or a spouse leaves you and you think it's the end of the world. But then later on, as you look over your life, you realize maybe that was actually the perfect thing to happen. So life is like a roller coaster ride. So fellow Toastmasters and welcome guests, the next time you encounter something challenging in your life, remember, it's like a roller coaster ride or it's like the kiddie park. And take your kids to the park. And then also, there's a concession stand. Now, we didn't go out to dinner much when I was a kid because they didn't have restaurants. But it was a very exciting thing to have those funnel cakes or a hot dog or the slushies that were so good. And that reminds me to take time to do things that are fun and exciting, and treat yourself once in a while. And then finally, Kitty Park was opened in 1952. And believe it or not, the same relatives of the family members are running that park because they believe so strongly that children should have the opportunity to have a very special place just for them. And that reminds me of the value of family. And believe it or not, if you happen to find one of those tickets in your jewelry box or a drawer in the back, You can still use those tickets at Kittyland today. So that's the story of why this life is like an amusement park.